It's time for your daily crypto update with Framework Fortune Crypto. I'm your host, Ben. Now let's dive in. So today we saw a crash across all the markets. The SPY took a very big drop, the Dow Jones. Gold took a little dump. Silver took a dump. And of course, cryptos took a dump. Now, if you're new to cryptos, if you just got in, you know, say Bitcoin at 48, 50,000. Maybe you bought the top up here at 52,000 on this recent run. This is a pretty dramatic drop. I get that. If you held through this, you're probably sitting there pretty sad right now. But anybody who's been in cryptos a long time knows this pullback is not that big of a pullback. We did just run from 30,000 to 52,000 on Bitcoin. So dropping from 52,000 to 42,000, that is a 50% retracement. So it just corrected to the halfway point of this last rip. If I take all of these drawings off, right there's where we're at. Right here's about halfway through this rip. With the 50% retracement this quick, you usually see some type of bounce. So I'm expecting there's going to be one in the next day or two. Now, if we do not get this bounce, and this is on Bitcoin and Ethereum, which, of course, if they don't get it and continue to drop, will drag the rest of the cryptos down, then it could be the end of this bull run. We have a downtrend now confirmed with this last two little peaks. If I was to draw it, it'd go straight across there. So until that downtrend breaks, which is around 50,000, Bitcoin will continue to stay in this area. If it drops any lower than this, it does have lots of support at 30,000. And I personally think 30,000 may be the new floor for Bitcoin. So we could see it back down to 30,000. It's all going to depend on the next day or two, whether we get this 50% retracement bounce or we continue to sell off. I don't like the fact that the stock market sold off at the same time as the crypto market. I've been saying all year that I think they should be reacting differently. However, a lot of investors still look at cryptos as a speculative investment. And it is true it is speculative because we've only had Bitcoin for 10 years or so. And the stock market's been held up by Facebook, Google, all of the tech companies, which are speculative growth companies. Most of them don't pay out dividends, or if they do, they're very small. So while Bitcoin is following the stock market, that is going to continue to bother me as looking at Bitcoin as a store of value, because the point of a store of value is that you store your value. And if the asset you're buying into drops with the stock market, well, then that's not a very good store of value. Take a look at Ether. Ether is a little bit different story, where it's still on an uptrend, where Bitcoin's a lot more volatile and it doesn't look like it's on an uptrend at the moment. Ethereum is still on that uptrend. It confirmed this uptrend back on July. So it could sell off, but it's got an uptrend that's more than likely going to hold. So Ethereum does look pretty nasty right now, but I think if it comes down to 2,500, that's definitely a possible time to look for maybe entering there close to the 200 and the trend line. But back to what I was saying, if you're new to the market, this drop seems dramatic, but looking over the past year, this drop is a pretty minuscule drop. It's not that big of a deal. We had a way bigger drop in this initial rip earlier in the year. So seeing that, if you bought at high prices, take this as a learning lesson not to buy into the hype, but actually do your due diligence and learn some technical analysis so you can buy in the dips, because I didn't buy any of the cryptos I have up here at these prices. I bought all the cryptos I have down here at the bottom of this trend line, besides a few that I bought back here at the start of this rip. So it's the same old adage that everybody says and jokes about, you buy low, sell high, but that seems to work extremely well with cryptos. Now, that 3,000 area of Ethereum was very strong support, so to see it crack right through it like that, maybe a little bit of overselling. If we see buyers continue to come back in and it pushes back above 3,000, then this could easily get back up to 3,500 in, you know, a few days or something. Is that going to happen? I don't know. To be honest with you, at this moment, I don't have a good idea of what's going to be happening here in the short term. Long term, I think cryptos will continue to get bigger and bigger as they're adopted. But we're in very, very hot water now. If you haven't seen, Biden wants to mint a $1 trillion platinum coin to put in the Federal Reserve to help pay for some of these bills that they're trying to pass and spend all this money. If you know anything about economics, then you know this is a terrible idea. If you are new to trading and investing in economics, go research what happened to Zimbabwe and Venezuela when they tried to mint a $1 trillion coin or $1 million bill, whatever the government tried to do. It's a similar premise, and you will see exactly what path we're headed on. And that gives me even more validity for cryptos long term. But as of now, there's a lot of money moving around in all the markets, big money moving around. There's not any certainty of where people want to put their money. We've had high inflation. You don't want it in dollars, and gold and silver are not holding up. You really only got a few places left, real estate or cryptos. Real estate prices, depending on where you are, are at all-time highs. The average prices of houses have went up dramatically in the last couple of years. So we're in a real estate bubble, a stock market bubble, a currency bubble, a debt bubble, because we're $30 trillion in debt. Gold and silver is not performing well. Overall, this picture, though, of the cryptos, they've performed pretty well. So we need to see this split from where the crypto market does not follow the stock market. I think it's a psychological thing at this point. Big investors and traders see the stock market's going to drop, and they think the cryptos are going to drop because we've seen that pattern repeat in history. But that's because Bitcoin was so new. Now Bitcoin and cryptos have a $1 trillion market cap. Maybe not right at the second with this drop, but they were at a $1 trillion market cap. They should not be following what the stock market is doing. So I think that psychological barrier is something we need to see break if the stock market continues to crash for cryptos to inevitably go on an end-of-the-year bull run. But in saying all that, the short story is the short term is really, really hard to call right now which direction the cryptos are going. So we need another day or two to see if we're going to find support. It looks like we're trying, like I said, there on Ethereum. Bitcoin's got support under it. We look at the top gainer on the day. OMG has been pushing up, breaking over that $10 resistance. So that is an altcoin still going on a run even while the rest of the cryptos are dropping, which is a decent sign. And then CGLD, which I'm still swinging as well, turning green on the day after having a sell-off. So it's not like the crypto market has completely turned upside down and is just crashing. We still got altcoins that are ripping up, which just shows me that there is money still coming into cryptos regardless of what's going on outside. We're just not getting a whole bulk of money because of all the uncertainty. So that's why you're seeing a lot of cryptos dump, which some of these were already really high anyway. I mean, Solana had ran way up there, so it needed a pullback. That was the original rip, and it just pulled back here. So in comparatively to the original rip, Solana's not even that low yet. And we're going to see that on a lot of these coins as I'm flipping through here. A lot of these pullbacks aren't that big of a deal, because the cryptos that weren't running were already at these lows, and the cryptos that were running are holding up pretty decently. So I still am holding my little bit of Cardano, like 300 coins. It's pulled back to $2. This could be a possible buying opportunity. It held up back here. and seems to be trying to hold up here. If we see a little green day, it looks like we're going to start coming back. You know, that possibly could be an entry, but not seeing the hype that it should have got off of that upgrade, it looks to me like it may try to pull back to 150. But it still has a chance to stay bullish if it stays above 2. Now, Adam, of course, ran all the way up to 45, so this pullback down to 32 is not that big of a deal. Adam was at 32 only a week ago. So it's just back to the prices it was a week ago. That's not really a big drop or anything. That's just a correction. And you can already see where buyers are starting to come in at 32 to try to push it back. I am in the boat of getting hit hard because I am still holding FET. And you can see it's just dumped and dumped and dumped. I'm holding quite a position of it, the 800 coins. So I should have got out, but I really thought this was going to have more of a push. And this pullback just ruined its momentum. However, it is holding up the 50-day that just started there. We do have some support right across there at 65. But I was really looking for 75 to hold up. So if it drops any lower than this, I'm just going to eat the loss. But I'm going to try to hold to see if it gets a bounce. And then maybe I can add around 75 cents if we start to come back up. Because I still like this project long term. But in the short term, it may be a little sketchy. Now, Luna's pulled back, but it's just pulled back to this original support area, the bottom of this channel, where it consolidated for a few weeks. And it's getting bought up there off of that 25. So again, this is another one that may present a buying opportunity to here, as this pullback is not that big of a pullback compared to the move. But that's all the coins I'm going to cover for today, because there's just too much uncertainty tonight. What's going to hold up and not hold up tomorrow? Same thing in the stock market. It's just question marks right now of what's going to happen. Let's hop in the news, see if there's anything interesting there. So it looks like there was an OpenSea scandal that happened. But I don't know if that's actually an OpenSea scandal or if some nonsense happened, and maybe this is biased media trying to take a dump on cryptos. See, Brazilian Investment Bank launches crypto platform. So this is another South American country that's adopting cryptocurrencies. If you've been following me, I've been saying I'm starting to get real bullish on South America, the way they're adopting cryptocurrencies faster than the rest of the world. If they could all come together, that'd be a big dominant force for the rest of the world to have to deal with all of their resources. And the power of blockchain and crypto behind them could be an interesting real estate bet to take a look at. So right here we're seeing direct interference with the market. And when people say that America has a free market, this is the shit you show them and you say, no, it's not. The SEC said it would sue Coinbase should the exchange launch its Lend program. So Coinbase drops this Lend program that could have made a lot of people money because the SEC didn't want them to do it. So this product was going to power a crypto savings account that would earn customers 4% annual percentage yield, APY. A return that's multiples higher than most savings account at traditional banks. I'm going to read this last part again. A return that's multiples higher than most savings accounts at traditional banks. So the SEC attacked Coinbase, and it's to protect us from a savings account that is higher, a crypto savings account that gives you a higher yield. That means you make more money than your normal banks. And that's a problem. And this is why we've got to continue to push for adoption of decentralized currency, because of nonsense like this. The SEC has not done anything in the stock market. If you're just joining the crypto markets, the SEC has not done anything but give traders headaches. If you're not familiar with the stock market, there's a rule called the PDT rule, pattern day trade rule, which states if you're on a margin account, which a margin just means that they're loaning you money against your money so you can trade with bigger position size. I don't recommend it for you as a new trader, but if you have under $25,000 in your margin account, you can only trade 3 times a week or you will get a fine from the SEC as being a pattern day trader. If you can figure out the logic behind that, pattern day trader rule, maybe you can figure out the logic behind why they're trying to sue Coinbase for putting out higher interest yield savings than normal banks. Tell your friends, get everybody you can on board with cryptos. Not everybody has to buy them right now. When I'm saying we need to adopt and get it out there, I'm not saying to buy at high prices. I'm not telling you when to buy or sell, but we just need to continue to educate people about cryptocurrencies and decentralized blockchain applications so we can get rid of all this centralization that is overreaching. If there's any coins that I'm not currently covering that you'd like me to cover on a weekly basis, leave it in the comments down below. Appreciate everybody joining me as always. Stay safe out there. Until next time.